My confession started like, you know, being in the club, you know, you got a lot of women in there for a lot of different reasons. Some just in it for, you know, the money to promote themselves, to further their career and their other interests. You know, you got some that's in there looking for a baller, somebody to take care of them. You know, I think when I first started indulging in the strip clubs, going for that entertainment, you know what I'm saying? The most memorable experience I had is going to the bar, like me and 8 or 9 of my homeboys, and we sitting there at the bar, you know, I think we was drinking it's Patron or whatever. A chick came over, she wanted some shots, so we started drinking with her, whatever, and my homeboy, he kept buying rounds for her. And you know, we asked her, like, you know, what she wanted to do later, what she was doing later, et cetera, et cetera. She was like, well, she's, you know, try to stay in the club because it's where the money is, et cetera, et cetera. You know, I looked one way to catch a dance on the stage. I ended up looking back the other way where they was. And basically, he had her up on the bar right in the middle of the club, yes. You know, crowd of people around, you know. So it kind of left an indelible impression on me about, you know, the potential in the situation, being in the club. You know, I was a young guy.
He had her on a bar. What was he doing? Like sexual?
He was. It was like that. He was going ham. You know what I'm saying? Like he was all in it. And bartenders weren't paying him no attention.
Okay.
You know, crowds standing around, and they was just going at it. It really, there's so much going on in the club. Club was so packed. Those club called Sensations. Columbia, South Carolina, we're in the building. Club called Sensations, and you know, it was a phenomenal place. You know, a lot of women in the club, probably like, you know, 80 women in the club at the time. You know, and it was like early 2000s, so, you know, strip clubs was really popping. So it was the first time I had a chance to really, you know, see again where this thing was headed. You know, feel me? It's like, you know, it's I'm 10, 13 years into this now. I've been around entertainers. You know, I done met all kind of entertainers from different walks. Like I said, everybody got a different perspective. They out here for different reasons and stuff. And, you know, it kind of opened the door for me to see the potential in the situation. So I've been, I own a soul food deli now, put it like this, right next to a strip club for one reason. Because the money come all night long. You know what I'm saying? The girls get the money, I get some money. Everybody happy, you feel me?
What's the name of your establishment?
The name of my establishment is Cynthia's Soul Food Deli. I named it after my wife. She's the one of the primary cooks in the establishment. So you come to Columbia, South Carolina, you got to stop. We got nominated for the Hoodie Awards, Best Soul Food in South Carolina. So, you know, like we here, we going to be here. But again, that was probably one of the most memorable things that I done seen a lot of things happen in strip clubs, you know what I'm saying? But that was probably one of the most memorable. StripperCabConfessions.com, support the hustle.
You look confession, you look.